I guess I'm talking about limiters. Limiters and you know, humans, I guess they're humans. I guess they can be animals also, but limiters. Like, you know, maybe they want you to be fat, and so they, you know, kind of make you uncomfortable everywhere you go to exercise, and so thusly it's not as easy to stay thin. And so that's a limiter. So when people have limiter personalities, they're controllers. They attempt to be controllers. And so in that identification of the controller, in the saga of war and self, you have to strive away and realize, well, to heck with you, I don't care. You're gonna drive me away because you have a problem. Then so be it. I will not be the folly of the excessive want of one's control. So in retrospect, the fight is now how to maneuver into another spectrum of its realities. Because right now I'm like, well, you know, someone's trying to stop me from being thin, you know, they want me to be fat, you know, and for me as a dancer, it's very, very heinous to stop me from dancing. So right now I'm like, well, forget it. I'll just dance here at the house then. I'll wear my pointe shoes here, you know, as long as I can. And I'll fast. I'll go on more fasts. I won't eat as much. And so, thusly, they do not win. But that's how terrible the fight is, the fight. And I don't know what it is. It's jealousy. They want to be ballerinas. They have jealousy. Males. Are they gay and they just can't handle it? I don't understand it at all. I don't understand the extraordinary, overt control. Like they are something extra special. Because they spin a bicycle in the middle of a room. I mean, it's absolutely abhorrent. I mean, they should ban the species, the people who do it. I mean, go take your bicycle out onto the streets. I mean, how stupid. Studios are for dancing, they're not for bicycles. So anyway. You know, really, I mean, what a disturbance, you know, to put that in the middle of the ballet salle. Yeah, they're ballet studios. They're for Tai Chi, they're for yoga, they're not for disturbers. And they're absolute disturbers. So anyway, so they're driving women away, they're making them fat. I believe so, because women can't even go there. They can't yoga. They can't even go there and stretch. They can't even have a normal exercise routine. And so I'm like, well, so we have controller males that are jealous of us and want the women fat. So, you know, to hell with them, and thusly, I guess so. We're gonna have to work out at our houses. We have to work it out at our houses more, and fast. It means not as much eating. We have to cut down the food by at least one third to one half every day. It's a disgustant, but that's war. You have to have the answer or you lose. And by losing, you become fat, the fat self you did not want to be. And I'm not picking on people that are heavy. I'm not meaning to pick on people that are heavy. If people want to be heavy, they can be heavy. My God, there's beautiful, heavy women, and they're happy with it. But for me, I can't be that way. It's just, I've been heavy before, and it was awful. So, I really feel like it, though. I really feel like they're like gay men that have some kind of jealousy. They have a jealousy syndrome. And with that jealousy syndrome, oh my gosh, I just broke my comb from my hair. Well, I don't need it anymore. I won't go out as often, you know. So anyway, that's in that announcements. It was fun doing the Chenets, though. I did like it, and I grand jetéed a little bit. I'll try to. I don't know. Maybe drive another car there. Maybe that's the answer. Maybe my truck is too announcery. Darn it.